video lecture of Ganit Pravinyam. In today's lecture, we are going to solve the next questions in exercise 5. Okay? See, the next question is, some composite factors of numbers are given below. Find their prime factors. So, if you see these examples, question number 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20 in the exercise 5, their factors are given. These are factors, 4 into 10 into 42, but they are composite factors. They are those factors which are given there, they are composite numbers, right? What we have to do? We have to convert these composite factors, or we have to split those composite factors into prime factors. Understood? The factors which are given, you see 1680, and its factors are 4 into 10 into 42. So this 4 into 10 into 42 we have to split again in the product of prime factors. It's very easy. Okay, see here. 1680, example number 16, 4 into 10 into 40. Now see, we will first talk about 4. 4 is product of which two prime factors? You know, prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23 and so on. Okay, so these are prime numbers I have written here. So 4 means, how can you write which two prime numbers? When you will multiply, you will get product 4. Yes, 2 into 2. 4 means what? 2 into 2. 2 2's are 4. So 2 2's are 4. Okay, we have split 4 into the product of two prime numbers, that is 2 and 2 again. 2 2's are 4. Similarly, this multiplication sign I am writing here. Similarly, 10. 10 can be split into which two, product of which two prime numbers? Yes. 10 means what? 2 5s are 10, right? 2 5s are 10. 2 into 5. 2 5s are 10. See, these 2 2s are 4. These 2 5s are 10. Multiply by 42. 42 can be split into product of which two prime numbers? Can you tell me? 42. See here, 42, if you must split into two product of prime numbers, two, what we get? Either you get 7 into 6. 7 6 is 42, but 6 is not prime number. 7 6 is 42, but 6 is not prime number. Again, we have to split 6. Okay? So I have written here 7 6, but again, 2 into 2, this I am writing as it is, into 2 into 5. Into 7 I am keeping as it is, and again 6 we need to split because 6 is not prime number. Okay, so 6 can be split into product of which two prime number? 2, 3 the 6, correct? So 2 into 3. So 2 2's are 4, 2 5's are 10, 7 2's are 14, 14 3's are 42. So this is the these are the prime factors of the number 1680. Understood this question? See, here factors of this number were given, but those factors are composite numbers. We have to find the prime factors. So what we have done, these composite factors we have split into the product of prime factors. That's it. What we have not done anything separately. Those composite numbers just we have split into two product of prime factors. Okay, that's it. Next one, see, 5670 is equal to 15 into 18 into 21. So if you see these numbers, 15, 18 and 21, these are composite numbers. What we have to do is, we have to split them into the product of prime factors. Now 15 can be split into which two, prime numbers? 5 3's are, or 3 5's are 15, okay? 3 5's are 15. Next, multiply by 18. See, 18 directly cannot convert into product of 2 prime numbers. Because 18 is what? 2 9's are or 6 3's are. 2 into 9. I will take here 2 into 9. But 9 is not prime number, 2 is prime number, but 9 is not prime number, so again 9 we need to split further. That we'll do later. Now see, 21, 21 can be split, 7, 3 are 21, okay? 3 into 7. So here it is not coming to the end because still 9 is opposing numbers. Rest all right as it is, 3 into 5 into 2 into. Now this 9 is the opposite number. How can you split into product of 2 prime numbers? Yes, you know that 9 is what? 3. 3s are 9. Right? And 3 is prime number. Again 3. 3 3s are 9. Finish. 3 3s are 9. 9 2s are 18. Okay? And this 3 into 7. So this 3 into 5 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 7. These are the prime factors of the number 5670. Understood? Let's go for the next. The number is 7452 and its composite factors are 12 into 9 into 69. So we have to split 12 into the product of prime factors. Similarly, 9 we have to convert into the product of prime factors and 69 also same. So 12 is for, see directly you cannot split 12 because 12 is 2 into 6. 2, 6 are 12. In this pair, 2 is prime number but 6 is not. Okay, so further 6 will split into the product of prime factors. 9. 3, 3 are 9, correct? And both 3 and 3 are prime numbers. 69. Now you know 69, how can you split 69? 69 is a table of fixed prime number. 23. 23, 3 are 69. 23 into 3. 23, 3 are 69, okay? Now remain only 6. That will convert in now 2 into 6 means what? 2, 3 are 6. Into 3, into 3, into 23, into 3. So these are the prime numbers or prime factors of 7452. Okay? So in this way, when composite factors are given, you have to find the prime factors. You can convert the given composite factors into the prime factors in this way. Understood? So in this question, example number 19 and 20, you have to solve by yourself. Understood? Pause this video, write this in your notebook. After this, we will solve next question. The next question is, write down the following numbers as the product of their prime factors. Means what we have to do? We have to find prime factors of these given numbers. Okay? So let's find, we have done it previously, how to find prime factors. First, write down 576 in this way. Okay, now you know the divisibility test. We have to apply the divisibility test of prime numbers. You know, if we have prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11 and so on. So first, we will check whether it is divisible by 2. What does divisibility test of 2 says? If the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the given number is divisible by 2. So here last digit is 6 in 576. That means this is divisible by 2. So let's divide it by 2 and check what answer we are getting. 2 2's are 4. 5 minus 4 1 remains. 7 came down. 2 8's are 16. 7 minus 6 1. And 2 8's are 16. 288. What we are getting? 288. Okay. See here, when we divided 576 by 2, we got answer 288. Understood? Now let's divide 288 by prime number. So 288 is divisible by which prime number? Again, the first prime number is 2. Is it divisible by 2? Yes, last digit is 8, right? So write 2 here and divide it by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, then 2 4s are 8. Again 2 4s are 8, 144. And 144 is divisible by? Yes, 2. Now divide first, we divide to 14. 2 7s are 40, remain 4, 2 2s are 4. 72 we got. Again, 72 is also divisible by first prime number 2. That is, there is 7, right? So 2 3s are 6. 7 is not there in the table of 2. So 2 3s are 6. From 7, 1 remain. That will be carried forward, so it will become 12. 2 6 are 12. So answer we got 36. When you divide 72 by 2, we got answer 36. Okay. Now again 36 is divisible by 2 as last digit is 6. So when we divide 3 by 2, we get 3 ones are 2 ones are 2. 3 minus 2 1. That will be carried forward. It will become 16. 2 8 are 16. Then you know that 18 2s are 36. Okay. Again, 18 is divisible by 2. 2 9s are 18. 3 3s are 9. And 3 1s are 3. Understood? So, these are the prime numbers of prime factors of 576. So, if we want to write 576 in the form of the product of their prime factors, what it will be? How it will be? 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, again 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, again 6 and 2 more times 2 into 3 into 3. Okay? Into 2 into 3 into 3. In this case. Understood? Next. 143. Now is 143 divisible by first prime number 2? No, because its last digit is 3. That means it is not divisible by 2. Is it divisible by 3? What does divisibility test of 3 says? Sum of the digits should be divisible by 3. So you see 4 plus 1, 5, 5 and 3, 8. 8 is not there in table of 3. That means it is not divisible by 3 also. It is not divisible by 5 also. Let's check by 7, 7 to the 14 and here 3, it's not divisible by 7 also. 11, is it divisible by 11? What does divisibility test of 11 says? The difference between the sum of the digits in the even place and sum of the digit in the odd places should be 0 or multiple of 11. So see here. These are odd places 1 and 3. Right? So the sum of 3 and 1 is 4, and this is 4. So 4 minus 4, 0. That means it is divisible by 11. Let's divide it by 11. 143 divided by 11. Okay? 11 is 11. 44 minus 1, 3, 0. 11 3 is 33. So answer is 13. 11, 13 is 143. Now if you see 13, 13 is prime number itself. So it will be divisible by 13 itself. 13, 1 is 13. Finish. So 143 is equal to 11 into 13. Okay. Similarly next, let's go for the next 2401. 2401. Now see, last digit is 1, that means it is not divisible by 2, our first prime number. It is not divisible by our first prime number 2. Let's check by 3. 2 plus 4, 6, 6 and 1, 7. It is not divisible by 3 also. Is it divisible by 5? No, because last digit is not 0 or 5. Is it divisible by 7? See, let's check whether it is divisible by 7 or not. Seven threes are 21. 3 remains 0. 7 fours are 28. 0 minus 8 means 10 minus 8 2 is 0. Yes, 7 threes are 21. Yes, it is divisible by 7. So when we divided 2401 by 7, we got answer 343. 343. Okay? Now 343 is divisible by which prime number? Last digit is 3, that means it is not divisible by our first prime number 2. Is it divisible by 3? 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 and 3 10. Sum of the digit is 10 and 10 is not divisible by 3, so 343 is also not divisible by 3. Then next prime number is 5. Here last digit is 3. It is not 0 or 5, so it is not divisible by 5 also. Then is it divisible by next prime number 7? Let's check. 7, 4 is 28, 7, 5 is 35, right? So there is 34, so we'll take 7, 4 is 28. 14, 2. 14 minus 8 is 14 minus 8 is 6, and here 0. 63, 7, 9 is 63. Yes, it is divisible by 7. So when we divide 343 by 7, we got answer 49. And now 49 is divisible by which prime number? If you observe it properly, you will come to know that 49 is divisible by 7 only. 7 7s are 49. 7 1 is 7. So 2401 can be written in the form of product of prime number in this way. 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. 4 times multiplication of 7. Okay? Next. 1768. See, now last digit is 8, that means it is divisible by 2. So write 2 here, divide 2 by, divide this number by 2. So 2 8 is 16, from 17, 16 will be subtracted, remain 1. So then again here begin number 16, 2 8 is 16, correct? And 2 4 is 8, 884. Try to divide on the spot, if possible. Then 884 again it is divisible by 2 because last digit is 4. 2 4 is 8, 2 4 is 8, 2 2 is 4. Again it is divisible by 2. 2 2 is 4, 2 2 is 4, 2 1 is 2. Now it is not divisible by 2. Is it divisible by 3? 2 plus 2, 4 and 1, 5. It is not divisible by 3. Is it divisible by 5? No, last digit is 1. Is it divisible by 7? 7 3 is 21. 1 3 means no. It is not divisible by 7 also. Then is it divisible by 11? No, not 11 also. 13? 13 1s are 13. Remain 9. Yes, it is divisible by 13. See, seventeen. Okay, because 13 ones are 13 and 13 sevens are 91, so answer is 17, and 17 is again prime number itself. 17 ones are 17. Okay, so 1768 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 13 into 17. Understood? So this way we have to find prime factors of the given numbers. In this, under this question, the example number 25 is also same. You have to solve it by yourself. Understood? So today we have learned this. Questions from 16 to 25. In that, whatever sums you have not taken, I have given for homework, you have to do it by yourself. Okay? So, if you have any problem regarding this, you can ask me. Thank you and have a nice day.